called my Hong Kong style prawns, but with a little bit of a twist.
Okay.
Because in Hong Kong, we have the fantastic seafood, very, very easily done. Mm-hmm. You know, delicious fresh prawns,
yep.
And then just butterflied garlic, spring onion, some Shaoxing wine, and steamed.
Okay.
And it gives a natural flavor of the prawns. But today, I've brought salted yellow beans. Have a taste of that.
Okay. So, and this is your twist, is
this it? This is my twist, because this is an ingredient that is very prominent, used in Hunan dishes.
Never tried
in the southwest region of China.
They are salty, aren't they?
It's pungent, it's salty, it's been fermented, it's got wine in there, salt, some chilies.
Is that the seasoning that it's bringing to the dish?
Yeah, it's the seasoning that's bringing to the dish.
It's kind of seasoning and texture, isn't it?
And texture, absolutely. Yeah. And it's got this beany flavour, so it's really well-rounded, you know.
Okay, so what's going on here? So you've got these beans. There,
and not many, what, about a tablespoon?
Half a tablespoon, generous tablespoon.
Okay.
A pinch of dry chilli flakes,
Yep. Okay,
and a little bit of sugar, just a pinch of sugar, just caster sugar. Okay, and that just complements it, not too much, because we've got strong flavour, we've got the savoury and a little bit of sweetness.
Okay,
now I've also got here the carrots, the celery, and of course fantastic juicy tiger prawns, some chives and some ginger.
So
these have just been deveined, that's fine, it's lovely.
So what, sorry, and that was soy in there or the wine vinegar as well?
That's just soy in there.
Right, okay.
I haven't added any Shaoxing rice wine,
okay. But
I'm going to add some of that in there.
Just tell us about this. This is essential in your cooking, isn't it?
Yes, absolutely.
What does that bring?
I really believe that is the secret to cooking a good Chinese dish, especially if you're just starting out.
It's not unlike sherry, is it?
It's a little bit like sherry, but it's a little bit drier than that. Mm. And what it does is, when you just take a mouthful of it, I just feel that it makes everything taste a little bit sweet. It brings out like the sweet sensations on your palate.
Okay. Yeah. So you just use a splash. It's not like using white wine in French cooking. Don't bring it down and intensify the flavors.
No, absolutely. Just as a condiment.
Okay.
And usually, as you start to cook the meat or fish or seafood, you just add a splash of it.
Okay.
So now, once the wok nice and hot.
Okay.
Right.
So in with the carrots.
So just tell me about the heat. Whenever I've seen woks being used, they're always smoking hot. And is that how you always want them?
Yeah, we want it smoking, and then add the oil in there.
Mm-hmm.
Give that a good toss. And not too long as well. We don't want to overcook the vegetables. I love the vegetables when they're just lovely and crunchy.
Okay.
And just as they start to turn just slightly translucent.
And what sort of oil would you usually use in Chinese cooking?
In Chinese cooking, it's very, very popular to use a good groundnut oil or a flavourless oil, because nothing that's going to compete, you know, with the flavour, because you're creating the different layers of flavour.
Yeah.
Fermented just a little bit, just to season the vegetables.
That was quick.
Then I cook that and put that on one side. Okay.